Hello, and thank you for downloading the February 2017 edition of the Data Science Central podcast. This is Tim Addison, your host and co-founder of Data Science Central. To get things started, I'd like to first thank TIBCO for sponsoring this month's Data Science Central podcast. We appreciate very much TIBCO's support of the Data Science Central community, and we are honored to have them sponsoring today's event. Today's podcast is entitled Visual, Predictive, and Streaming Analytics. Digital Business Transformation. Before we begin, I'd like to briefly review the format of today's podcast. Today's event will be approximately 15 minutes long, and we have just a single presenter that I will introduce to you right now. I'm very pleased to introduce today's speaker, Michael O'Connell of TIBCO Software. Michael is the Chief Analytics Officer at TIBCO, developing analytics solutions across a number of industries, including financial services, energy, life science, consumer goods and retail, as well as telco, media, and networks. He has been working on statistical software applications for the past 20 years and has published more than 50 papers and several software packages on statistical methods. Michael did his PhD work in statistics at North Carolina State University and is adjunct professor statistics in that department. Thanks for being with us today, Michael. We're very happy to have you and looking forward to your presentation.
Very good. Thanks, Tim.
My pleasure. Businesses want insight and action rather than more and more data. Big data does not always equal value, but analytics and insight do. And they don't have to be complex, expensive, or even big. Forrester has identified a new industry category, enterprise insight platforms. Combining visual, predictive, and streaming analytics in a closed loop that makes it easy to translate analytics-derived insight into action. In today's Data Science Central podcast, we will discuss this next wave in analytics, inside platforms. The podcast will include sourcing and wrangling the right data, enabling analytics insight using visual, predictive, geo, and streaming analytics, implementing the resulting insights into action on the business, and finally capturing data on the outcome for continuous improvement. So, Michael, with that, I'm going to turn this presentation over to you. And you can begin as soon as you're ready to go.
That's great. Well, thanks. Thanks, Tim. I'm just sharing my screen now. Let me know when you see it.
Yep, looks good. You're ready to go.
Very good. So I'm going to talk about the Insight platform and digital business transformation. And, you know, all data begin as real-time events. And those events can be brought down into a data lake, for example, to do analytics. But the insights from those analytics are perishable, and you only have a certain amount of time to act on them. So that's what we're talking about today, is how do we turn those events into data, into analytics, into insights, and then take action on those insights before they perish. And so we are riveted on this at TIBCO, my company, firstly being able to interconnect everything, people, processes, APIs, data, and systems to provision the appropriate data for the analytics. And then secondly, on augmenting the intelligence of your organization to allow visual analytics, predictive analytics, and streaming analytics on data that are flowing as well as on data lakes, and bring all that together. So the way that comes together on the visual side, finding recommendation-driven insights into business and operations, and then predicting, modeling the business and system behavior using data big and small, and then sense and respond to take action in the right moment to produce the business outcomes. And you'll see the little light bulb in the brain there for visual analytics, the sigma for the predictive analytics, and the computer with the data coming out of it as the streaming analytics icon as we go through today. And on the visual side of things, you want to access, analyze, and wrangle the data to provision it for the predictive process where you get a model and that's able to take a prediction, make a prediction. Could be a simple rules model or a more advanced machine learning model. And then the streaming analytics to take that model, apply it to real-time data, and get from the score of that model to make a decision, take an action, and monitor the results. So this way, going from insight to action across those three analytic areas. So if we think about this a little bit more on the learning side, to get the insight, that access wrangle analyze model gets you an insight, and then when you take you capture that insight into some rule or model, you can then deploy that out on the operations side to make a prediction from that rule or model, make a decision, take an action, monitor the results. And when you put all that together, you have this insight platform that Forrester has been recently writing about and that a number of companies are investing in, including us. And on the insight side, this is the real data discovery piece. And on the action side, this is the deployment of that insight. And we have a number of products for doing that that discovery and that insight execution. So I'm going to take you through the discovery part, the visual analytics, into the model, and then out to the streaming analytic and the action from the model in today's presentation. So starting off on the visual side, you know, it's important to have a good collection of visual analytics that is rich, that has rigor, accuracy, you know, scientific components, so that you can faithfully represent and get the true facts or the true visual, spot the fire in the data as you start to explore, bring the data in and explore it. And so being able to build a dashboard to understand what are the factors, say in this case affecting oil production, what are the how is that geographically occurring, what are the individual trends for different operators, wells, and so on. So get a feel for the key features of the data that you're exploring. And being able to connect to a lot of different data sources to enable this is imperative in a discovery tool. So cloud-based sources, enterprise, relational sources, big data sources, web services, you know, the list kind of goes on, and it seems to be accelerating. There's a new data source almost every day that you want to be able to connect to. And so having a software application that is able to connect to all those sources and provision that data, you know, mash it up in a environment that allows you to explore it, to discover, you know, insights visually. And, you know, being able to connect to those same sources as the data are in motion. So event enabling the data sources to, as an event occurs, to look at it in motion, to apply an insight as the data are originating. As I mentioned, all data begin as an event. So it's important to not just have those connectors I showed earlier to the data lakes and the relational data sources, but to also have those connectors to real-time data sources as the events are in motion, being able to connect to those data and to be able to event enable data that's sitting in relational sources to combine context into the real-time data feed. And so we think about having a two-speed architecture is very important. As the data are coming in as events, we want to ingest those events through messaging, APIs, integration of data sources and systems to be able to process those data in the stream to normalize, filter, transform, enrich, and so on. And then the two-speed part comes in where you take those events, you know, down into a data lake where you could look at historical data and get patterns to form the insights. But also on the real-time side, you want to be able to process those data as they're coming through in the real-time stream and to have some back and forth between the insights obtained on the batch system being applied to the data as it's coming in the real-time stream. And then the ultimate then is to take an action or an outcome from the stream that might be kick off a business process, send somebody a notification, you know, basically take action when the data, the critical data are flowing in the system and before the insight is perishable to take an action on the insight. So that's a key part, is just the ingestion and discovery of the, you know, of the insight, you know, from the data. Now the modeling part, you know, this is where the data science kind of stuff comes in. And, you know, we've tried to create the components for a data science environment that allow the data scientists to find the insight and codify it into a model and also mass communicate the power out to the audience. So our visual analytics platform, Spotfire, has an embedded R engine both on the client and on the server. It's easy to work with in terms of once you created an application, you know, it's a one-click publish to the server that now a person in a web browser can follow along and see that model, see that insight in action on their data. And then the ability to extend to lots of other stats engines that support machine learning and deep learning capabilities on the server, and then have a library or a repository where the components such as the data access, the visual components, the modeling components, the functions that invoke the models can be shared and stored and reused across the data science team. And it's also important to have a community where the data scientists can form and share their results and be able to bring in data functions and analytics from the community to inform their analysis. So those are some of the components that are critical for this middle section of creating the model and where some of the investments we've been making to support that, that community data science effort. Those are some of the key components that you need to have that data science function be able to produce the components that we're talking about. And so that that combination of visual and predictive analytics allows an organization to develop analytic applications that capture insights in different key business critical systems. So being able to deliver proactive customer service, provide cross-sell offers at the point of sale, predict the impending failure of a piece of equipment, manage inventory in real time, optimize pricing, detect and prevent fraud, optimize routes in the logistics, transportation, supply chain area, and anticipate and handle disruptions. These sorts of operations systems are at the core of businesses, and insight platform type methodology has the ability to digitally transform and create enormous value through these key critical business systems. And so as the data flows in, that two-speed architecture that I mentioned before, we have a number of other product components that are important in managing that real-time stream. So the stream-based analytic platform, the business events, the rules-based system, and the live view of the data from a live cache, allowing the analytics to be performed in the live stream, but also visualized live in the live stream. These are some of the important components that you need and where our investments have been made. So if you think of the insight discovery area with, this set of developer tools, R, Python, NIME, Spotify, H2O, these are some of the popular development tools for obtaining the insight discovery. Now, as the model is identified, being able to push that out as PMML or PFA or a plain old Java object or some proprietary format is another key component of the insight platform. And then being able to execute that insight in situ through a microservice, or this is the part where the data science and the DevOps have the handshake for taking the insight that's been discovered into execution on the production environment. So this whole flow from visual to predictive to streaming is really where the action is happening, where the insight has been identified and now it's going to be executed to take an action on the critical business system. So that's the insight platform in a nutshell. Some customers that we've been working closely with, Occidental Petroleum, who's using this platform for remotely monitoring a collection of artificial lift systems in oil and gas production, UCMC for real-time identification of cardiac arrests, a logistics company, Cargo Smart for real-time analysis of sea traffic conditions. Vestas, a wind turbine company, using this to model and simulate weather and turbine data to optimize production and turbine performance. And then, real-time oil and gas drilling and monitoring from a variety of customers. So today I don't have time for demonstrations, but I'll point you to our community site where there's a number of videos and demonstrations taking you from the data science piece into the engineering app and out to notifications. For industrial Internet of Things applications where data are coming in, you're analyzing them on the fly and then giving an alert to a relevant person to take a look at the equipment. Or on the customer analytics side where the data science allows you to find customers who are have a propensity to buy a certain product in combination with another product or based on their purchase history, so that as they're on your property, on your website, you can give them a sensible offer that they have a high chance of consuming that's contextually relevant and historically to the purchase history relevant, and people can understand and take a monitoring view on top of this. The call center, the agents, the help system, the point of sale system all have visibility into that. So a couple of quick examples of this, you know, on the Oxy side, managing spot fire and stream base for continuous surveillance on the electric submersible pump systems, on the cargo smart area, you know, digital business growth for developing increased sophistication and demand on the suppliers of people who are putting the products onto the containers, quickly understanding how to get the products in there, and then the vessel managing the speed with respect to the route, the weather conditions to reduce fuel consumption, and you know, manage the docking process both at the beginning, the origin, and the destination of the journey. You know, on the Bank of Montreal side of the house, this is a customer analytics transforming the business to look at omni-channel, you know, the online banking versus the in-teller experience, the different products, the mortgages, wealth management, being able to kind of combine those, that cross-sell, getting you know, lots of improvement in offer acceptance and reduction in cycle time. And then on the Vestas example I gave, these folks have got more than 30,000 turbines out in the in production, getting data at the rate of 1,000 data points per minute per turbine. So lots of data, and being able to understand that data and when there might be an issue to make take an action. So, for example, remote de-icing, understanding performance, you know, being able to remotely monitor. So we sort of think about this digital nervous system of equipment and customers that we're able to understand, get insight, models from that, visual insight on the data, and then put those models into motion to, in this case, do remote maintenance on the equipment. So I'll point you to the community site. There's a number of these case studies that are up there and some demonstrations. You know, the community address is here. I'll give you a quick tour of it. But this is the address if you have a moment. And the community site has a number of components that you can download to get started, you know, on the software, a number of machine learning methods, customer analytics templates, fraud detection templates, and then these accelerators for connected vehicles, you know, tracking the tracing the logistics and transportation assets, case management. There's a number of accelerators for cross-sell on Apache Spark, industrial equipment, industrial Internet of Things type examples. And the, you know, this inside platform, as I mentioned, Forrester's just done a big wave on it. And there's a number of vendors who are out there, you know, providing these systems. These create extreme value on the business, which is kind of contributing to the traction and popularity in the market. But let me give you a quick tour of the community site, and this might be something that you can go and explore at your leisure. A little bit of what is an insight platform, the Forrester, you know, report, what the components, as I mentioned today, visual analytics, predictive analytics, streaming analytics, some more information around that, you know, the process. We had a recent webcast on this. Some of the industry solutions I mentioned, fraud detection, customer analytics, with links across to other components that you can download, equipment monitoring, energy solutions, and then some of the customer stories that I mentioned, the Vestas wind turbine application, the cross-sell, the Bank of Montreal, the Cargo Smart Logistics. You can go and look at those videos, you know, at your leisure. But you know, if we go across and take a quick look, you know, there's demos here on the customer analytics side that you can go and run, the Spark Accelerator, you know, that sort of thing. This links across to other parts of the community site. So for example, the analysis of the sensor data for equipment monitoring and maintenance. You know, there's a variety of components there that you can explore. So that's really it. So kind of this podcast is a quick introduction to the world of insight platforms and some of the assets that are available out there. You know, we're certainly making big investments in this. Our customers are. A lot of other software vendors are active in this space. And, you know, I invite you to take a look at the community site, to contact me either through Twitter or through email, or follow my Twitter feed. And thank you so much, Tim, and everybody else for your attention today.
Thanks so much, Michael. That was a great presentation and a wonderful overview of the new technology. As everyone can see right now, Michael's contact information is there, so I'm going to leave the screen up as we wrap up. I do have a couple of quick follow-up questions, Michael, if that's okay. The first one is, how has Insight Platforms emerged as interesting to different types of businesses?
Oh, yeah, great question. That's really the core of it, is that the businesses see the ability to transform their business with this type of technology. You know, if someone's at the point of sale in a retail store, you know, that's the time when you have them. That's the time that you want to leverage their customer history, their current purchase, and put something in front of them. You know, if a piece of equipment is about to, you know, fail and create a whole lot of expense and downtime, you know, you've got, you know, you want to know about it right then, and you want to take an action right then. So this is the idea of the having the analytics, but this perishability to the insight that you need to act. And so getting to that action has an enormous impact on the business. So all those examples I gave today, the business are really driving those and pushing their analytics and DevOps and IT teams to transform their digital operation to, you know, get to this value. And it's really that business value that's sort of driving a lot of the interest, you know, in this sort of technology.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. Okay, great. Thank you. Connected to that is, who do you see are the users and the buyers of Insight Platforms?
Yeah, so as we saw in the loop here, there's a lot of different components. So there's the analyst who is exploring the data. There's the data engineer who's provisioning all that data. You know, there's the business user who was trying to get visibility onto the system, the business system of interest. You know, and then there's the business owner, you know, who has that desire. So, you know, there's lots of people that are involved in this. That's kind of why it's a platform. And so, you know, all of those become important touch points, you know, to this. And that, you know, that sort of loop here involves necessarily a number of different constituents on technical side, IT side, business side.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. So one final question is, as we look down the future and the horizon in front of us, how do you see 2017 and the future of this technology?
So it's great that Forrester has kind of recognized this as a hot area. And, you know, they're a very reputable firm, obviously, an analyst firm. And, you know, we've been at this for a while. You know, some of the other vendors on that wave have been at this for a while. But it's really starting to come into focus. And this notion of being able to do something with the data in real time, informed by your analysis of the historical data, people are just starting to realize that that's where the value is. It's not in the big data lake of data that you've downloaded, you know, over time or whatever. It's being able to take insight out of that in a way that can inform a real-time business process. And so we're seeing, I think the, you know, the emergence of this space and these sorts of businesses are all sort of jumping in. You know, how can I maintain my equipment in real time? How can I manage my logistics processes? How can I manage my customer experience? These sorts of business applications are, you know, in terms of transforming the digitally the business operations. It's just a natural evolution, and I think we're getting to a bit of a tipping point, and it's pretty exciting that this sort of data from is being looked at in a real-time setting for, you know, the creating digital network on your business, on your customers, on your equipment, for taking real-time action, and how the all of this historical data that you've kind of been collecting in data lakes and so on can be used to generate those insights and apply them to the business to create enormous value. So I see 2017 as a year where this is really starting to come to a head, customers want to get competitive advantage by taking action on their data as it arrives to them to just get them a little bit ahead of their competitors. So I just see the 2017 being a big year for this Insight platform, Tim.
Yeah, I think you're right. It's an exciting time. So with that, I'm going to let us wrap things up here. Thanks for the thoughtful response to the questions. So this brings our podcast to a close. I want to thank TIBCO again for their sponsorship of today's Data Science Central podcast. And again, a special thank you to Michael O'Connell for his insight into today's topic. My name is Tim Madison. I'm very pleased to have been your host for today's event, and we look forward to seeing you again at our next podcast. Have a great day.
Thanks.